I started working at a mapping company in 2003. It turned into a really cool job, and I love the technology and products we made. I've always been an early riser, and the folks I worked for didn't mind me coming in before the sun came up so that I could leave early and beat the afternoon traffic home. Arriving early meant that I was alone for at least a couple of hours in the early morning, and I'd get a lot of work done. One year we had a series of back-to-back nor'easters, big heavy snowstorms that rolled through New England, and I got stuck at home for a couple of days. Finally, I was able to drive in with my truck, but conditions turned my one-hour track into 2 hours. Even so, the sun still hadn't come up when I arrived. The parking lot was covered in snow, and that was unusual. The guy who managed the building kept the grounds in impeccable condition, and this is the first time the parking lot had snow on it when I arrived. It's an easy bet that the nor'easter had caused a backup of snow removal for the area. The good news is that all the lights were on, inside and out, and I could see clearly through the window the house-sized globe, Eartha, that our company was famous for, and it was slowly spinning away on its indoor axis. I could also see that there were no tracks on the snow around the front of the building or in the parking lot. I was first. I parked close to the front door and kicked a trail through the snow up to the entrance. It was damn cold, and the snow was over 2 feet deep. Eartha had a big room surrounding it with 3 observation levels. Visitors could walk up an indoor stairway to the higher levels, and each level had its own observation balcony. During normal hours, you would find busloads of kids walking up and down the stairs, visitors standing on the balconies taking pictures or reading a brochure, or watching Eartha's slow 2-axis spin. Some folks might sit on a bench and stare at the globe. Many people spent lots of time staring. It was a trippy to look at. I used my pass and key code to get through the outer doors, walked through the breezeway, through the interior doors, and into Eartha's room. The giant globe silently rotated. Since I was carrying my lunch, backpack, and a cup of coffee, I started walking toward the elevator so I could take it up to the 3rd floor. That's where my office was at. But something caught my eye and froze me in my tracks. There was a guy standing on the 2nd floor balcony, staring at me. I'd say he was probably 30 years old, wearing a couple of sweaters and a blue beanie. But he had an absolutely crazy expression on his face, and I'd swear his eyes were bulging out slightly. Something wasn't right about this guy. Since the elevator was in the public space, and it would come out on the 2nd floor right where he was at, I decided it would be safer to get into the secured stairway, which requires a key fob to get in. I got in, pulled the door closed to make sure it actually locked, and I looked through the 3-inch slit that was in the door there. You know, it faced out into the area where Eartha was at. The guy had moved along the balcony to be closer to where I was, and when I looked up at him, he had squatted down and was staring at me through the plexiglass barrier. But now his hands were fists, and he had them pressed up against the sides of his face. His lips were moving like he was mumbling something, and he looked even crazier now than he did before. My heart started racing kind of fast, and I was a little bit taken aback by this guy. I wondered, could he have a weapon or something hidden? And why? How did he get here? Why was he here at this time of day? So I shot up the stairs and keyed my way into the 2nd floor. This was the personnel area for the company. And if you walked straight back from the door, you'd come to the windows that separated the employee area from the balcony area where tourists would be at. I knew I could get a closer look at the guy from there, and I'd have safety glass between me and anything that was out there. I got to the first window and expected to see the guy staring in at me, but he wasn't. I was glad about that. I looked up carefully, left, right, as far ahead as I could see over the balcony, and I could see the spinning Eartha out there, but the guy was nowhere in sight. So he must have gone either up the stairs or down the stairs for the public area to, you know, the lower or upper deck. So I went around to the balcony door, and it's a door that goes for employees. You can go back out onto the balcony and leave if you want, using the regular public stairs. And I went out there, opened the door, just enough to lean my head out and say, "Hello?" There was no answer, no footfalls, nothing at all. Absolutely quiet. Eartha spun on its axis like always. I pulled the door closed and made sure I heard the lock engage. I returned to the secure stairwell and went up to the 3rd floor. Like with the 2nd floor, I was able to approach the balcony window, and I expected to see the guy looking in, but he wasn't there either. I walked to each window, looked left, looked right. No guy. So I walked to the balcony door, blocked it open with a nearby chair, rested my backpack and coffee on it, and I walked over to the balcony and looked down. Nobody was staring up at me. Nobody was on this side of Eartha. And since it was dark outside, the windows were like mirrors, and the reflection revealed nobody on the far side of Eartha, and nobody was on the first or second levels. By this time, I was even more scared and was trying not to imagine the intruder sneaking up behind me. I took a deep breath and walked slowly down the public stairs to the second floor, making sure nobody was there. Then I went to the first. Nobody there. I took a lap around Eartha. Nobody. I went to the entrance doors that I had just come through minutes before and looked out. The only steps visible in the snow were mine. Holy shit, I thought. What an idiot I'd been. The guy was still in here with me. I bolted back up the stairs to the third floor, pushed the chair back into the room, and pulled the door closed. I jogged to my office, went inside, and closed and locked the door behind me and called the building manager. I got his voicemail. In about 10 minutes, my phone rang. It was the manager. I told him there was a strange person walking around inside the building. No, I did not recognize him. Good to his word, he arrived and was through the front door and at my office door within 5 minutes. He lived nearby. The manager didn't knock, he just called my name. I recognized his voice, opened the door, and he told me he'd looked around and didn't see the guy anywhere out front, and he was about to go down and check the security tapes. A few minutes later, I got a call from him. Bad news. The recording had stopped after the extended power outage, and the system didn't come back until just now. He'd had to manually start it. He checked what video there was, and there was nothing of record of the last 48 hours. The door sentry system shows only my entry into the building and my movement around through the security doors. So this fellow, this visitor, he must have found another way in, and none of the sentry systems had logged him. And it must have come in that last 48-hour period where the power had basically been out in the whole area. The stranger never showed up on the video record. I never saw him again, but I won't forget the crazy look in his eyes or how stupid I was to try searching for him. I'll always wonder how he got into the building and why he was looking at me like that. I can't help but think it all could have ended a lot worse than it did.